Milwaukee, Oklahoma. We're here for the U.S. Skydiving Championships. Well, hello, everybody. I'm Bobby Eddy, and usually you'll find me on the ground. Today, I'm in a DC-3 climbing to 11,500 feet. We'll have competition in 4, 8, and 10-way team competition. Working with me is surfer, pro football player, would-be skier at times, and also a skydiver, Russ Francis. What can we look forward to?
Bob, what we're going to see is the 8-way competition. 8 men going out the door into formations. They'll have 50 seconds to get about 5 formations completed. It's spectacular to watch how they are all synchronized in the air. We'll be right out there with them.
I'll tell you, Russ, this looks pretty insane to me.
Well, it's time to get out of this airplane, Bob. I'll see you on the ground.
All right, Russ.
Want to come?
No.
Good night, buddy.
Good luck to you, pal.
Bye-bye.
See you, Bobby. Bye, guys.
I think this is one jump I'll stay up here for. Actually, I'm scared just watching him bail out. I wonder how Bill Walsh, the head coach of the San Francisco 49ers, feels about all of this. Actually, Russ has had over 500 jumps. He started jumping 2 years ago in Hawaii, so he's had a lot of experience, and you have to have a lot of experience before you try anything like this. He's traveling at 120 miles per hour. He bailed out at 11,500 feet. Huh, there goes that chute. Actually, he does have a reserve chute. If that one had failed to open, he'd be okay. I bet this is more fun than training camp.
Looking over the landscape, boy, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Bobby Eddy, I wish you would have come with me. Here we come in for landing, getting ready for the toggle, pulling down to slow down, and one split. Boy, that wasn't very hard at all, was it?
Woo! Boy, was that a lot of fun. Listen, Mr. Bobby Eddy, eat your heart out.
Last.
Above Davis Field, lots of skydiving here the past few weeks. Nearly 1,000 competitors from all across the country. We're getting ready for the final stages of the competition. Elmer and the Glue Bags currently in second place in the 8-way competition, getting ready for their 10th and final jump. And these are the ground video cameras used in judging the competition. And Russ, why don't you kind of go through the judging for us?
The judges here in the room have an unenviable task of trying to score each formation. The competitors have 50 seconds in this 8-way competition to do a series of 5 formations. Once they turn those 5 formations, they start over again and they're scored a point for each formation they complete. These are the 5, the diamond flake. These are very difficult. We'll see them in the air. The zipper, trying to complete these formations while in free fall at 120 miles an hour is extremely difficult. The donut, the springbok. It's difficult, but also a lot of fun. We'll be seeing these formations up close, the open-facing diamond. These guys are ready to roll.
Elmer and the Glue Bags ready for their 10th and final jump. They have 68 points, and that's the combined number of successful maneuvers in all previous 9 jumps. They're 5 points behind the leader, Visions, so they need a really good one if they're going to win this.
It's extremely important, Bob, that they get in real tight here on the exit because they want to be as close to each other in the air as they go out the door. Look at this. They're taking the entire 8-man formation right out the door. That's almost impossible.
Almost an explosion out of there.
They have to get down to start these formations. You can see them even before they start to get stable. They get in free fall, Bob. It takes about 10 seconds before they hit terminal velocity or 120 miles an hour.
You know, Russ, it must be a tremendous amount of concentration for them.
You really have to keep your eyes open as we watch the springbok formation here. They'll be opening back up into an open-facing diamond. It's really important that you watch your teammate next to you and mentally visualize what the next formation is going to be because it happens so quick. They fall right along with each other, trying to keep pace. It's important that one man doesn't fall even just the slightest bit lower than the other. Into the donut again. As we mentioned before, they have to keep on going through the sequence of formation. These 5 formations scored a point for each one they complete.
Amazing timing, too, Russ, when you think that this is the first time this team has ever jumped together in competition.
They really are doing well, and we see what makes up a skydive here in this slow motion. The puzzle, putting the puzzle or the formation together. The angles of the formation, trying to swing your legs around like this in the donut formation is very difficult at this speed. The keys, a man nodding, when to break a grip, when to go into the next formation, and the flow, the rhythm and timing. And another fun part of the jump, knowing that you've done well and gliding, sailing safely to Earth.
Also knowing that you've just been in a free fall for nearly 9,000 feet over 50 seconds and coming out of there, the Golden Knights representing the Army, they're in third place with 60 points. And these guys have really jumped a lot, Russ. They're from Fort Bragg, North Carolina.
They get to jump just about every day, Bob, and they do a lot of work on these formations. They're going to really be tough in this competition.
Tremendous spirit amongst this Army team. I've been watching them on the ground going through all their maneuvers down there.
There is truly a real spirit and camaraderie amongst all jumpers, Bob. You can see the Army guys along with Elmer's team and the Visions. They really get along well. They really cheer for each other.
It is kind of a special little world. You know, they look like little bees up there, don't they?
Yes, they are. And these little bees, aside from doing all these nice formations, looking down at the roads, looking down at the farmhouses in Muskogee, here at the lakes, where am I going to land?
I don't think I'd be looking down at the farmhouses.
They've done a real good series here, Bob, and you'll see them start to break away and fall away to pull their canopies. This is called tracking. Track away from the man next to you so you don't run into each other in the air opening your canopy.
And it looks like a good jump for the Army, and we'll have to wait and see if they move up in the standings.
And we're looking at the square canopy here. They're a lot more maneuverable than the old round canopy or parachute. You can see this skydiver coming in, working the brakes, pulling back down, steering, slowing, coming in for a nice soft landing.
And earlier we watched the demonstration on packing those parachutes.
With me is two-time world champion skydiver Mike Guinness, and we're here to pack a parachute. Packing is not necessarily difficult, but for obvious reasons, it has to be done right.
That's right, Russ, and we'll start right here at the nose of the parachute. We've already checked the lines, so we can just accordion fold the line groups on top of each other.
What is the most single important thing at this stage?
Well, the most important thing at this stage is to make sure that we have the lines with equal tension on them. As you can see, we're going to have to do a little dressing up here before we move on to the next stage.
To make sure it opens.
Well, yes.
Now that we have the canopy at this stage and the lines are straight, we'll be folding it up to put it into the deployment bag so it comes out even for opening. Mike, explain to the folks at home what we're doing now.
We're stowing the lines on the deployment bag to prevent any chance of entanglement as the parachute opens.
Well, I'm going to stand here and watch you since this is my parachute.
You're tough. Okay, the bag goes into the container. We'll close it up. How do we get it out?
Well, we take this little pilot chute and doing 120 miles an hour, we throw it into the air. If everything works right, it pulls the main parachute out and we float home safe and sound.
To jump again.
That's right. And now we get a look at what it's like in free fall. You'll see the skydiver reaching for his stomach for his pilot chute, lets that go, and the wind going by his face at 120 miles an hour brings that pilot chute up, which pulls out the main canopy. You'll see the lines unravel, the canopy come out, and once again, your little anti-gravity device saves your life.
A member of the first place team, Visions, looking over diagrams of the jump that's about to be performed, their final jump in the competition. Talking it over, and everybody has their own way, contemplating another way through a little meditation. Another member of Visions, and our pilots, Mary Jane and Sally. We'll be back. Getting ready for their 10th and final jump, the team Visions. We had a chance to watch them earlier on the ground doing a dirt dive. Let's watch.
Ready, set, go!
And this is where it all begins, the dirt dive. Doing the jump, getting everything in order before you ever step off the ground, getting into the plane. Working through the puzzle, the formations, the keys, the flow, the rhythm and timing. Trying to do the jump exactly on the ground as you'll do it in the air. And having fun doing it. And these guys like to have fun.
It's showtime!
They've also had a lot of jumps together. They've been together as a team since 1979. And here they come out of the plane.
And this gives you a good idea what it looks like exiting the aircraft. It really gets your heart pumping, and it's important that they really stay as close together as they can on exit so they can start making the formations as soon as they get stable. You'll see them turning into the donut formation right now, and they've been going pretty... Oh, there's a break in the formation. They've got to go back and reform the donut formation, otherwise they'll lose that point. And they've gone back, they made the signal to go back and do the formation over again. The next formation will be the spring box formation, and this is a difficult formation to do. This series, the Diamond Flake, the Zipper, the Donut, the Springbok, and then the open-facing Diamond, which you just saw, back to the Diamond Flake, that is a difficult series of formations to do. They've only been getting an average of 8, 9. They've done as many as 13 points or formations in any one jump.
And all of those formations while they are dropping at a rate of 120 miles per hour.
Wow. They've really come back well after busting that donut formation, Bob, and you'll see them tracking away now. They really gathered themselves together. That has a tendency to break your concentration, but they really pulled it together.
And the chutes are all open, and here are some skydivers of the future. Russ, let's take another look.
Again, it's very important that they really exit close together. Visions is almost starting their formations before they even get stable. What a great shot of our cameraman with about 14 pounds of equipment. He's having fun looking down the formation, flying right along with everybody else.
Also, that uniform, that loose-fitting uniform, actually aids in his flying, doesn't it?
It really does. It has to be cut a little bit larger for the cameraman because he's carrying so much more weight. The competitors' suits are quite a bit slimmer because they need to be agile. They don't need all that wind resistance on their suits. And here we come in for a real nice, soft landing. Now, that's fun.
Hey! Not bad. How'd it go?
Very well. I think we did the job.
You think you got the first place all nailed down now, right?
I think so. I hope so.
Any surprises up there?
Well, we missed a grip on our donut, but we gave the reform signal and went back and got the point. I'm happy about that.
And that's Mr. Craig Franck, one of the more experienced skydivers in the country. You'll see him on the left of your screen giving the re-grip or reform signal. A couple of his friends over there in the formation pick up the signal and give it to the other guys. They go back. This takes years of experience. That's why they're so successful. They're really cool in the air.
You know, it must be really wild up there. Here you guys are going about 120 miles an hour in a free fall, and you got to worry about a grip. Well, how do you handle it?
Don't even notice the free fall. It's all relative to the other people. It's everybody's falling the same speed, so it's just like you and me standing here next to each other.
Can you guys talk when you're up there?
No.
No conversation back and forth?
No, it's all hand signals or something like that if something has to be signaled.
Well, Russ, we'll just have to wait and see how much that misformation cost them. Here's a little girl packing her father's chute. We'll be back with the final results of the eight-way competition. Results in the eight-way competition. Visions held on to finish first. Elmer in the glue bag second, and the Golden Knights were third. Earlier, Russ, there was competition in 10-way.
And this is a completely different event, Bob. The rules and attitudes are completely different. The idea here is as soon as a man crosses the plane of the door, the judges start their clock. They fly down into a circle, or what the skydivers call a star. And a time of 10 seconds in this event is regarded as a very respectable score.
And the winning team, and we're looking at them right here, the Freak Brothers, had the lowest total time for all six jumps. And in their last jump, the sixth jump, they tied the world record, 8.3 seconds.
And that's moving, Bob. I'll tell you, they got out of the plane really quick, and now it's time to hang on and enjoy. They've got about another 20 seconds in free fall where they can all look at each other, yell and scream. It's really a lot of fun at this point.
A little mini celebration at 120 miles per hour, right? The second place team jumping out at an altitude of 7,500 feet, the Beer Hunters. And they broke the world record with a time of 7.9 seconds.
What a tremendous effort. Not quite good enough to win first place, but I'll tell you something. It's not every day, and this is the first time in history anybody in competition has broken 8 seconds. 7.9. That's getting there in a heartbeat.
And the winner of the 10-way competition, the Freak Brothers, really had a celebration.
They certainly did, and they deserved it because they performed consistently, and they really hung in there together. One of the interesting points, Artis Reith here, the first woman in national team competition to win a gold medal.
And later today, we'll be seeing the 4-way team competition, and here they are getting ready. This is the Team Fire. They jazz themselves up. And the Team Ice practicing their formations, which they do over and over and over again. And one of the top teams representing the Army, the Golden Knights. We'll return to Muskogee, Oklahoma later for the U.S. Skydiving Championships. Hi, I'm Bob Beatty back in Muskogee, Oklahoma for the U.S. Skydiving Championships. Nope. West France isn't the only one that can do this. There's more than this, Russ? Oh, let's get back to the competition.
And next time I'm taking you with me, Bob, you won't escape my clutches. But meanwhile, we're back for the 4-way competition for some complex maneuvers. The catacord, the marquee, the Chinese tee. opal, monopod, exotic names, but very complicated and very hard to do in the air. They'll have their hands full. And after nine rounds of competition, we're looking at fire. They're leading Mike Guinness, Scott Meek, Craig Franck, Mike Parnell, and David Wilds. Only four guys jumping at one time, but they rotate on a five-man team.
Okay, and they jump out of the plane at 9,500 feet, and they have to make their formations in a period of 35 seconds. But now, 35 seconds is a long time to be free-falling at 120 miles an hour.
And you notice, too, Bob, they take the four-man, everybody, right out of the door. They'll be doing their maneuvers before they really get horizontal to the ground. They'll already be working their maneuvers, not wasting any time at all. Right now, before they're stable, they are going through their first series of maneuvers with the catacord, and then the marquee, then onto the Chinese tee, the opal, and the monopod. And this is a very tough series to go through, and they've got 35 seconds to do it.
And these skydivers have really had literally thousands of jumps getting ready for competitions like this. One of the team members, Craig Franck, did a kind of an unusual thing a few years ago. He jumped out very near the North Pole. And here we see one of our cameramen flying into the picture, getting some excellent pictures.
They average about 2,000 jumps a man on this team, and Mike Guinness, who's also on this team with the tan leather hat, is a two-time world champion. So they've got some very qualified people on this team.
And Russ, here they are again in slow motion.
And you can really get a good idea how they move through the air, how they use their hands and their legs to shift their weight. And coming into this 10th and final round, fire was leading the competition. They have put together a very fine series of formations. We're looking up at Scott Meek with the white helmet. He's the captain of the team. And what a beautiful sight. And another beautiful sight. Coming down, landing under canopy. Forward speed, 20 to 30 miles an hour. Very maneuverable. You can see the wind sort of gusting the canopy, flaring in for landing.
Oh, boy, and what a beautiful landing it is. Guys, it looked terrific to us.
It went really good. It went really good.
You think that puts the competition away or what?
Ah, darn, the Army's such a go-for-it team. There's just no telling. They can come from behind. It was a good dive. It was a safe dive. It was what we needed, I think, exactly.
Everything went just the way you wanted it.
Exactly, I think.
Nice going.
Thank you.
And the competition is really tight. Fire has completed all 10 jumps. Teams Ice and Army tied for second, yet to come.
Didn't just start out this way. They've literally had hundreds and hundreds of jumps. Earlier, we watched the student prepare for her first jump. Let's take a look.
And this is where it all starts, the first jump course. Joan Travis is in the process of learning the PLF, or the parachute landing fall. Curly Rowe, her instructor, is going to make sure that she lines herself up properly for landing.
Good landing. Good parachute landing fall. Let's try it again, all right? Let's move on up one more notch. Go off the high platform.
And this is about what it's going to be like when she comes for landing. About this height, she'll be landing into the wind to minimize the speed of the canopy.
Lots of tension.
Keep your knees and feet together. Steel springs.
Hey, good landing. Let's go on up to the harness. Do a little of that now, okay?
By the time this lesson is over, Joan will have gone through about 4 or 5 hours of training. She starts in the morning. She'll be jumping by the afternoon.
Ready?
She's now on the harness. She's practicing her exit from the aircraft, getting used to all the familiar surroundings, the risers, the ripcord, and her reserve.
Good pull. Nice arch. Put it back. Let's try.
She'll practice normal opening procedures. She'll practice emergency procedures. If her main canopy does not work, she has to release it completely away and then pull her reserve. Right now she's practicing a May West malfunction, which means a line over the main canopy not allowing it to inflate. She just cut away her main canopy, released it, so that when she pulls the reserve, it will not tangle with her main.
Let me get in first.
This is when the blood starts pumping. Get near the airplane, okay, get the feeling of leaving the ground and knowing that you are soon to be hurled out and down.
Door open. Five right. Cut her back.
You'll notice that Joan is looking at the ground even now. I'm sure she's preparing herself for the moment that she'll be hanging from this strut on the aircraft at about 2,800 feet as she simulates the exit.
Good job. Great skydive. Let's go suit up.
The next step is getting the gear on. She's gone through this procedure many times, and Curly will check double, triple, and quadruple check to make sure all of her gear is safe.
Hey, Joan, you might want to take this along with you.
Yeah, I might need it.
Okay, it's the real thing now. You all set?
I think so.
How do you feel?
A little nervous.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Well, now it gets exciting. This is the real thing. This is time to jump out of the airplane. And I can tell you one thing on Joan's mind right now, as it is on most first jump students. Am I prepared? Have I done enough training? And she's about to take a long fall. There she goes. The static line pulls the canopy out and it's open. Beautiful opening. Now Joan will come in for landing. She has a radio on her chest. They'll talk her down, right turn, left turn. When she comes in for landing, she'll land into the wind, her feet and knees together. She's got everything going for her perfect. She's got her feet together, comes in for landing, nice and soft. What a beautiful job. She's really been cool through this whole thing. And like most first jump students, she'll be back, and she's a very happy lady. I did it. I really did it.
Now we're ready for more four-way team competition. We're looking at a team called ICE. Team members Kent Lane, Irving Callahan, Dan Peters, and Mike Sharon, and they're about ready to go. Kind of going through the maneuvers in their minds, getting ready for that explosive bailout. They're going to need 13 points to tie for first place. They're tied now for second place. 14 to win. Well, they've gotten 14 points in two of the earlier rounds, so it is possible, isn't it, Russ?
It really is, and they've got to get right at it. Right off the plane, you'll see them. They're not even stable yet, and they're going through some of their maneuvers. That's very difficult. But these guys have practiced a lot together, and they're very capable of doing 14.
Well, they really did charge out of there.
They don't waste any time. They're having a good series so far. If they can stick with this, they've got a good shot at it.
We might mention that ICE is half of the eight-man team called Visions, which won the eight-way competition. The other half, the team that's now in first place in the four-way competition, Fire.
That's right, and now that we're looking at ICE, they're tied with Golden Knights, who were the national champions last year. So it'll be interesting to see. It's going to be a battle right down to the wire.
Okay, they really are frantic in going through these maneuvers, trying to get just as many as they can into the 35 seconds they're allowed.
And what the judges are looking for, too, Bob, as they break up here, good separation in between formations. You can see they're happy. They're shaking their heads. I think they believe they've got it.
Let's take another look at that in slow motion, Russ.
Watching a team like ICE perform, Bob, is really beautiful. It gives you a real appreciation. It gives you a real good feel for what it's like to be a skydiver, to be flying through the air, and you truly are. To watch them in motion, and they're under a lot of pressure. This is the final round. Look at how smooth they are. Hours and hours of practice. It reminds me of a saying that skydivers have that we say many times over and over. Man small, why fall? Skies call, that's all. And they say it perfectly right here.
You do get a great appreciation for all the thousands of hours they put into this.
The free fall is fun. Now it's time for landing. You come on in smooth. It takes practice, but you tiptoe into the drop zone.
Okay, how'd it go?
Oh, a really good diet.
How many points you think you got?
Slightest idea. It's going too fast. We don't know.
Might have had enough to catch him or what?
We're going at a good rate. I don't know. To catch him, we'd really have to be going good. I don't know what's going on.
But you're pretty happy with it?
Yeah.
And the last team in the four-way competition representing the Army, the Golden Knights, with Andy Gerber, Mark Gabriel, Bob Finn, and Rusty Vest.
What kind of training are we doing? Army training, sir!
And Russ, they are really ready. As a matter of fact, last year they won this event, but only when they came from behind in the very last jump. Well, they've got their work cut out for them. They need 14 points to win.
Well, they're very capable of doing it. They've done it before in practice and in competition. They seem to be fired up. If they can pull the four men out the door, get their tongues back in their mouth, they'll have a good shot.
A charged up and very well-disciplined Army team.
They've done a 15 early in the competition, Bob, so they're really, look how fast they're falling. Again, 120 miles an hour, but it looks like they're just screaming to earth.
Russ, they're really flying through those maneuvers.
Well, this is the last jump in the competition, Bob. They're not going to hold back one bit. They're going for, look at how quick they're switching the formations. Talking with these guys throughout the competition, though, they're competing. This is the national competition, but they're having a lot of fun out there. They're doing something that they really, really enjoy, and all the other jumpers are rooting for them. They want to see each team excel. Look at the roads below. Give you an idea of how they're moving through the air. They're going for it. They've made a lot of maneuvers. We'll see if they've got it.
We can almost feel that adrenaline that they have.
I'm getting excited. You know, I counted close to 15, 16 formations. Now they're tracking away. What a feeling.
Well, they came from behind last year to win, but they really have their work cut out for them this year. They need 14 points to win to move into first place ahead of Fire. That would, I think, be a pretty tough job, but it did look like an outstanding jump. Take another look, Russ.
You know, this is really exciting for me, Bob, watching this Army team. It's their last jump. It's the last jump of the competition. It gives me what we call in Hawaii chicken skin. Bumps all over my body, just the adrenaline and everything else. It's really exciting to watch. They're going for every ounce they're worth and having fun doing it.
Pretty good timing up there, Phil, isn't it?
Oh, it's beautiful. It really is poetry in motion. I wish there were other words to express it more adequately, but they're all smiles, I can guarantee you that. That's a great jump.
And a nice, easy touchdown once again. And a high five from the Army.
Do you think that they thought they had a good jump? Here comes number three.
I think they got a good shot at this.
I think they've got a great shot at it, Bob. I'm calling that 15 formations. We'll have to see what the judges score in the 35-second period. But look how happy they are. They know they had a great jump.
Hey, guys, how'd it go?
Went real fine, real fine.
What do you think? You had 14 points to make up. Did you do
it? We broke off in the 16th point, and that puts us 2 points out of time usually during regular skydive. So we'll just have to wait and see, but it went real fine for us.
It's going to be close, though, right?
Sure going to be close. We're going to try and make it as close as we can, just one ahead.
And as one of our busy cameramen ends his day, we'll be back for the final results. The final results in the four-way competition in first place, Fire. Army ended up with 12 points within the 35-second limit to miss out by only 1 point. And 1 point behind them in third place, the team named Ice. I'll tell you, Russ.